Today we are going to talk about restyling a shot. That is character swapping, essentially. This is video 3 in the series, or is it 4? Debatable. Video 1 was about using Phantom for getting consistent characters into a video scene. In my case, I used The Highwayman and sat them together, in a specific order, at a campfire. This is all for my planned stage play called Surprise, Surprise, The Highwayman. So video 2 ended up being about memory management on a 360 RTX 12GB VRAM card. And then of course video 3 is about getting new camera angles, over the shoulder, preparing for dialogue scenes, which I make a video about later. So this video is the one I promised at the end of that last one, and we are going to discuss that Swiss Army knife tool of the Comifu world, the VACE model. And use that to swap eye quality characters back into the new camera position shot. We need to do this because in achieving camera rotation around my chaps at the campfire, I lost quality. Not a ride, even for my 361 2GB VRAM GPU. But today, I have engagements elsewhere because I am a very important pretend person. And so I am going to hand this video over to the delightful... What was your name again?
You took your time asking.
I think I was exemplary given you'd had 5 bottles of wine.
Get on with it.
Right, yes. Okay, well, ciao bambinos, I now leave you in the soft and delicate and rather experienced hands of, what was it in?
Sarah.
Yes, Sandra, you have the mic.
What a dick.
You know I am still sat right here, Sandra.
Vanessa.
Vanessa?
What?
No, I mean, oh, whatever.
Okay, self-centric poor performance alter ego has now left and I be taking over for the rest of this video.
Without further ado, let's get on and talk about VACE. First, do yourself a favor and seek out Nathan Shipler's notebook LM knowledge base that is all about VACE. I will share that in the description of the video, but let's briefly spin through it to get a feel for what VACE is all about. It really is the Swiss Army knife of comfy UI. Looking through the knowledge base, you can see there are a number of different things it can do, but it is all about swapping out areas targeted by masking, doing that by adding, removing, or simply changing them. It can also drive motion addition of the subject, and in some cases drive the camera too. But the catch is that it can be quite complex to get right. So let's define exactly what we need it for. Then I will talk about the workflow I use to get what I want in this particular situation. Hopefully you see a better performance than I did last night.
Oi, Sarah, I still hear you now.
Cindy, actually.
Well, are you sure?
Yes, I am. Let's talk about Mace.
Don't you mean Vase?
I think I know what I mean.
Medic!
Right, now that minor issue is dealt with, let's talk about Vase. So in this somewhat busy looking workflow, I walk you through what I'm doing with it. The first thing you notice is a number of things are bypassed. That's because it is like a Swiss Army knife and we can enable or disable features as required. In this case, I don't want the video aspect, just image creation. That is bypassed on the left, but I also bypass this the Phantom stuff in the top right because I haven't got it working with Vase yet. But we can ignore all that for now. I share this workflow with you in a link or a version of it. And so let's walk through the features as pertain to how we use it here. This is the model loading section. Now, Vase is a T to V model, meaning text to video. So it T'd and does work with Phantom, but I find I run into issues with combining them on a 3060 12GB VRAM GPU. But that is fine because Vase will work with any tech to video model, and my preference is currently using it with the WAN 2.2 low noise model. So you can see I have the E5M2 FP8 text to video WAN 2.2 low noise model loaded, and plugged into that is the Vase module. Now you could of course use a GGUF version or even a merged version without the module plugged in. The choice is yours. My preference. You are looking at it and you have already seen the results. This workflow will turn this into this and this into this If you have used VACE, you might be thinking, hang on, that's a still image. Doesn't VACE do video in? Well, yes, but no one said it had to be exclusive. I like to muck about, and in doing so, I discovered this works rather well, because VACE for video I can get maybe 540p resolution, certainly not more over 81 frames. But here, I can go to 720p and even higher if I want to, and as you can see, setting it to one frame, I get it done in about 5 minutes. 81 frames, it probably would not even finish. And in the context of this workflow, I am just trying to get base images that I use later for driving dialogue shots for each of the characters as they hold a conversation.
Here is an example. It's a very rough version, and you can see the overlap of the context window that allowed me to capture longer frames on the 3060.
Your language, your vocabulary, just communicate ideas. It's okay to make mistakes. It's okay.
I made this before the Infinite Type model came out using Multitalk and Fantasty Portrait, and I just let run here for a moment, but it's vastly improved code now, so this is a poor example of what the end result will be, but you get the idea. So you've seen the model, you've seen the results. Let's now look at what VACE does to get us there. First, we mask the new camera position with the low-quality character in. It doesn't have to be too accurate, and you want to test it out to find what works best. I have simply used the same image to inpaint the mask area in the node itself. In making a video clip, I would do this slightly differently, as I would use SAM2 to track the mask through the video, but for our purposes, this is all we need. That then feeds to what in the video workflow would be a middle grey mask, but I just use it here for simplicity. It gets the colour necessary for VACE to receive it as an input frame. And here you can see the VACE encode node is taking the grey mask reference as an input frame. And the mask actually comes for the Ovidian mask I showed you, but converted to black and white. So going back to the VACE encode screenshot and looking at the sampler node, you can see I am running 6 steps. That is because the LoRAs for Lightning and Fast One allow for that. I have config set to 1, which is standard when using LoRAs. Seed I discussed elsewhere, though it will be different between models. I had 43 in there because I was testing it with Phantom originally, but it worked fine with 1, 2.2 low noise model and VACE module, so I left it alone. And as always, I just use the scheduler I find loaded up unless for some reason I really feel the need to change it. LCM is because 1, 2.2 I think was originally suggested to use that. To be honest, I don't recall why, but I have a feeling I felt it was smooth than some of the others. A lot of this you can get lost down rabbit holes, so you have to pick your battles. And you are probably wondering what all my notes are about there, or you can ignore most of them. I think it was when I was trying to find a balance between VACE and Phantom, and in the end I parked the idea of combining them. Phantom and VACE should be the perfect mix. VACE gives you power to control everything, and Phantom gives you visual consistency. My feeling is you need a card powerful enough to handle both those models. I'm not sure the 3060 is that card. But it turns out I don't need to combine them. VACE with WAN 2.2 low noise model FP8 EP5M2 was more than enough in this case. Which brings me to the final part, the reference image. Now, this turned out to be the tricky part, but I resolved it in the end. You really need this reference image to be roughly in the same position as you want him to end up in the final frame. Location is important. Firstly, he needs to be on a white background. And many will argue he also needs white padding around the whole thing. I found padding to be hit and miss. Curiously, the hardest was the large guy when he was in the middle, not sure why. In the end, the way I solved it was take it to Krita and overlay my guy over the target image, then fill everything around him with white, then bring him back in as the reference image. That worked.
If you are getting weird results, try changing the reference image size and position and see if that improves things.
And that is about it for this video. Thanks for watching.